prepare some question for you. If you can answer the question correct, and you will get a lollipop. And here is question one. If supervisors disagree with us, what can we do? We answer the question first. And then here are our answers. First is finding a happy medium. And this is means that you follow some of your supervisor's suggestion and your supervisor take some of your opinion. That is find a happy medium. And the second is to follow the supervisor's opinion. The third is ask other supervisors. And last one, to hold on to your own opinion. But I think in this situation, you have to explain to your supervisor why you consist that your opinion. And here is a really question. In our timeline, when do the level risk two happen? Yes, you are right. It's data analysis. And there is another one. If I need to do some extra reading or interviews, what is the risk level of this work? Thank you for your listening.
这个是佩文问的那个问题，那他给我们两个选择，第一个就是他是问关于第三个风险，就是 failure analysis， 然后他说有两种，他说是因为我们用了错的方法，所以我们就是没有办法分析，还是说，或是我们一开始就是有一个那个错的题目这样子，那他就两种，然后大家都有就是发表一些意见，那。我们这里举了一个例子，就是说，因为我们一开始讨论的时候，我们也觉得它很模糊。那可是我觉得这有一件很重要的事情是，他说这个错误是 unexpected problems， 就是这是一个不可预期的错误。那我们觉得说，如果比如说像使用错的方法这件事情，我们认为它并不是一个 unexpected。就是它并不是不可预期的，应该是你当初设计的时候，你可能不是很完全了解，所以才会有。所以我们这里就举一个 例子在这边，就比如说我现在一样要调查那个买糖果的行为，那我可能发问卷嘛，买牛奶，这也是买牛奶，然后刚好我在做这问卷的时候发生了那个三聚氰胺事件，那可能会影响他们买牛奶的行为。可是我当初问卷设计的时候并没有针对这个点去设计它，所以我收集到我那个问卷回来之后，我收集到的资料可能就会有偏差。那我觉得在这个部分，你对这个资料的那个分析可能就会有偏差，那可能不是你原本想要的这样，所以我们就举了这个例子在这里。